गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज़ योगेन शर्मा. स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम हियर टू एक्सप्लेन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सब्जेक्ट. चैप्टर नेम इज़ चेंजिंग ट्रेंड्स एंड कैरियर इन फिजिकल एजुकेशन. इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न 5 पॉइंट्स. फर्स्ट वन इज द मीनिंग ऑफ फिजिकल एजुकेशन. सेकेंड वन, द एम्स एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ फिजिकल एजुकेशन. And third one is the career options in physical education. And fourth is the various sports at national or international level in physical education. And fifth or last point is Khelo India program, which is newly introduced in our country. So let us start. To understand the meaning of physical education, we must understand the meaning of education first. What is the education? Education is a process of learning which modifies our behavior towards progress. Towards progress, or in other word, it is a process of gaining knowledge. It is a process of gaining knowledge for the improvement of human beings. The word physical is related with the body. You know, students, as you learn, the education is the process of learning. So in the same way, we can understand that the physical education also a process of learning. But what is the physical education? It is needed to know that we can say that physical education also a process of learning, but in which we learn through the physical activities. The learning which is comes through the physical activities, that is the physical education. So we can say physical education is an integral part of general education. It involves physical activities which help to achieve wholesome development of an individual. Physical education develops body and mind both. It develops total personality. Physical education help to develop total personality related to physical, mental, social and emotional development of individual. Physical education helps to develop good health and leads the man towards progress and wellness. It leads to balanced development of an individual. Student, when we are talking about the topic name denotes the changing trends. So here we will discuss something about the modern trend. Modern trends, first we know what is the meaning of trends. Trends, a general direction in which something changing or developing, means in society or daily routine life, if there is something changing and developing day by day, it means it going to become a trend. Okay, modern trend have increased its importance as modern physical education stresses on balanced development of body and mind. It brings harmonious growth and development so that optimum health as well as a good personality can be developed. So now I understand through these points. Now you can understand the meaning of physical education. Once again, I repeat the meaning of physical education. As we understand the meaning of education. Education is the process of learning. In the same way, the physical education also a process of learning. But in this type of learning, we learn through the bodily movement and we learn through the physical activities. I think it is clear in your mind. Now we will discuss about the aims and objectives of physical education. Student, what is the aim? First we must know about the meaning of aim. What is aim? Aim is a highest possible achievement or the ultimate goal. We can say that if you have something, if you have an aim, we talks about the aim of physical education. What is the, before knowing the meaning of physical education's aim, we must know the meaning of aim. What is the aim? Aim is the highest possible achievement or the ultimate goal. Aim revolves around a definite purpose and it is usually one. Now we can say that we can't set two aims. If you are going to do something, you can set only one aim. But there are many objectives. But there are many objectives may change from time to time. And in other words, we can say that the objectives are the ways or are the route which leads towards achieving our aim. Aim kya hai? Ek ultimate goal hai which revolves around the definite purpose, or to achieve that one, to achieve the aim, there are many objectives, but they may change time to time, but your aim cannot be changed. Okay, so now here we understand the meaning of aim, and now now what is the aim of physical education? The aim of physical education is to make every child physically, mentally and constitutionally fit, to develop in him such personal and social qualities that help him to live happily with others and build him into a good citizen. That is the ultimate aim of physical education, to make every child mentally, physically and constitutionally fit. And now we talk about the objectives. As I told you earlier, to achieve or to attain an aim, there are many objectives. Suppose you have to go to Delhi. What is your aim? Your aim to go to Delhi. But how you can achieve it? To achieve it, you can go through the road, you can go through the airway, and you also go by the train. All these three things, roadway, airway and train, all these three things are the objectives which are helping you to attain your aim to reach the Delhi. I think it is clear to your mind. In the same way, to achieve the aim of physical education, to make every child healthy, we need four objectives. We decided four objectives by which we can achieve the aim of physical education. So here we are talking about the objectives of physical education. It talks about the objective of physical education. There are four objectives of physical education to attain the one ultimate goal of physical education, to make every child fit or healthy. The first objective of physical education is physical development, and the second objective of physical education is psychological development, and third objective of physical education is social development, and fourth objective of physical education is emotional development. So first we start with the first objective of physical education is physical development. What is the physical development? To achieve the ultimate aim of physical education, the objective of physical development has to be achieved. Without achieving your objective physical development, you cannot achieve your aim of physical education. According to this objective, body should grow in a proper direction, in a proper way. Physical activities help in developing the body. By doing the physical activities, we can develop our body only. Our body is a kind of machine which grow and develop with physical activities. Physical development improves our neuromuscular responses and leads to maximum organic development. By the physical activities, we can only improve our muscular, neuromuscular responses. Physical activities must be performed to develop optimum growth. This objective also guides a person to make fit, a person to make fit his body strong, well-shaped, good-looking, good working of internal organs, because good health and improves because good health improves the physical personality. So by developing physically, we can achieve our aim of physical education, to make a overall development of a individual. Now you can understand the meaning of this objective. This objective guides a person to make his body strong, well shaped, and good working of organs. And now we talk about the second objective. The second objective is psychological development. Why it is needed to attain your aim of physical education? This objective is related with positive thoughts, ideas, behavior, attitude, conduct, and responses. This objective improves the psychological balance of mind and body. The psychological development directs the growth and develop in sequential manner. In this stage of objective, the person develops in a sequence. First, the person learns the primary things, then secondary, then higher, then higher. Your psychology develops in a sequential manner only, which makes the citizen healthy. And this kind of objective also help to achieve the aim of physical education. Here we discussed about the three things, students, in this chapter. First one is, we have discussed about the meaning of education. It is a process of learning. And second thing, we discussed the meaning of physical education. It is also a process of learning, but in this term we learn through the physical activities. And another point we have discussed, the aim of physical education. What is the aim of physical education? The aim of physical education is to develop every child socially, mentally and physically fit, and the wholesome or overall development of an individual is a ultimate aim of physical education. And there are four objectives of physical education. First one is physical development. Second one is psychological development. Third one is social development. And fourth one is emotional development. In physical development, we learn that the body should grow in a proper direction. And this objective improves muscular, neuromuscular responses and leads to maximum development of human body, which guides a person to make his body strong, well-shaped and good working of internal organs. And second objective is psychological development. In this term, we have discussed that it is related with your positive attitude, thoughts, ideas and responses, which direct the growth and development in a sequential manner. Positive thoughts, ideas guides towards progress and make a citizen healthy. So here we discuss that four things. The rest of things we will discuss in next lecture. So I shall stop myself here. Thank you.